Hey guys, and welcome back to DocHack GU, and we have mail, but you already knew that from the end of last episode. Let's check our mail. I have mail from Syllabus. He wants to congratulate us on our match. So we are to meet him and Gaspard at our at-home canard. Before we go and meet them, we still have more stuff to look at. There's still plenty to see here in the community, including a new online jack.
This is Salvador Aihara's Online Jack! I'm here with the Online Jack crew near the home of Michiru Tajima, fourth grade teacher at a school where six students were struck down by doll syndrome. Let's continue our in-your-face investigation.
This is Salvador Aihara. Here I am, reporting from the residence of a female teacher. Samba, samba! Well, here I go. Help! Fire!
Oh no, a fire! Where?
Good morning, senorita!
Huh?
Truly a sight that could chill a 100-year passion. So tell me, the six children who contracted doll syndrome, had they been playing the online game called The World?
Well, they did get together and talk about an online game a lot.
And what are your plans right now?
I'm going to the Kawaguchi residence.
Osamu Kawaguchi? That's one of the six students who have been resting at home due to doll syndrome.
How could you possibly know that information?
Now we shall make our way to the Kawaguchi household, where one of the victims of this barbaric illness is being treated.
You're not coming. And stop following me!
Wait!
Not here.
It's summer vacation. Maybe he's on a trip.
But I told him I was going to visit him.
Eh? The meter's spinning like crazy, which means someone is definitely in there. Hello? It's me, Salvador Aihara, born in Brazil, raised in Saitama, friend to lonely housewives.
Hey, don't do that! You don't have the right to just barge into someone else's home!
But I'm sure everyone at home watching this wants to know what's really going on, right?
Huh?
I want to know! Even if we do break a few laws, he's the man of truth, that's Salvador! Hey, I hear something up there.
Huh? Osamu?
You heard it, didn't you? He did in fact say Sakaki. We have some other things. This one's talking about robot weapons in Japan. There's a movie to it.
The U.S. Army's new combat robot, Talos, is the perfect robot soldier. Its movement is controlled remotely, and it's armed with a machine gun as well as a 40mm grenade launcher. But more importantly, it has no fear, no family, and does not suffer any emotional stress.
So there's some other news. Here's some stuff that talks about online. Apparently in the world, you can marry online. This is the whole thing. And you can, like, virtually marry your characters to each other, and this man actually ended up marrying his mom. So, yeah, that apparently happens. That's kind of crazy. Onto the community forum. We have stuff about the world. Here we have them talking about Adept Rhodes into more of what they do, their class, why they have the multi-class. I think somewhere in here they even talk about Haseo, but there's a... Yes. I heard that the PKK, Terror of Death, was really strong. The Terror of Death was a rogue, right? So some rogues are strong then. I think it's a matter of individual player skills. Also, maybe he spends way more money on equipment and abilities. I bet he's got a lot of rare abilities. So, it talks about stuff like that. There's another place, another spot in here. Okay, here we go. Okay then, if two players of equal strength with equal equipment, equal abilities fight each other, one being a Brandir and the other being a rogue with the Brandir weapon, which is the broadsword, who will lose? And it's true, the rogue will lose because the rogue is not a true Brandir. So there you go. And here we have them talking about a bug. This bug, its HP won't go down. It's no status effects or work either. They couldn't run away with a smoke screen. Nothing worked. And then had black dots coming off of it. If you've played the original games, this automatically triggers in your brain from a memory from the past game. But if not, you'll soon experience just what this person's talking about. And we'll get into much more of this later. So, let's see. Stuff about Crimson Versus. This person actually talks about how Crimson Versus, there's a rumor going around that they're going to be making card games that you can buy in real life, and if the card games sell real well, they'll bring back Crimson Versus. As you remember, I've showed you before, Crimson Versus is down. The bad thing that I didn't like, if I have a complaint about this game, at least the first volume, is that I think it's dumb that Crimson Versus isn't working. You don't get to play Crimson Versus until the second game. So, that's a thing. This person, they're just talking about, like, a town that's completely run electronically. So, nothing really special, and I accidentally exited out of news. This is talking about comas with the world. People are starting to freak out because, you know, all the coma stuff is coming up, and every time someone's falling into a coma while playing a game, they're playing the world. It's not just some random game, it's the world every single time. So they're getting freaked out. You would get freaked out too, I'm sure. Here we have the rumor board. Oh, this is where they talk in the rumors about selling real cards. It was a rumor thing. So, I don't remember what the other one was about, but yes. I've scanned these before reading, or before coming here, that's why I know what they talk about. But, we have to go meet our friends, so let's log in, let's go see everybody. One thing I'd like to say right here, right now, this episode is very heavy story-based. There won't be any dungeon. It's all story stuff. Just as a forewarning. And we're not even on the right server. Shame, shame.
Be right there. sorry to keep you waiting, Sakaki.
Guess I'll stop by Kennard's at home.
Yeah, let's head to Kennard's at home and see what Silvrust and Gaspard wanted. That guy. From behind, he kind of looks like a wolfman and Terrace. Just wanted to make sure. What? Let's fit in, shall we?
You came! Thank you!
Haseo! Oh, Haseo! You were so cool! You were amazing!
Get off me! Hey!
Congratulations!
Congratulations, Haseo! And, I'm really sorry.
Why are you apologizing?
Well, I mean, we didn't do anything.
We just left everything up to you. Sorry about that.
Come on, you guys, cut it out. Get your heads up. I just did what anyone else would have done. I mean, after all, I am Kennard's guildmaster. It's my job.
Really? So you mean that you're not mad at us?
Don't make me repeat myself.
Are you okay with us? Is there anything we can do to help out?
Yeah! Can I help too?
Do what you want.
So as we can see here, more of Haseo's character development. And Haseo has always really been genuinely a good person. He just has his own way of doing things. And they may not be some of the ways that other people agree, but, you know, everybody goes with different strides of the kind of people we are. The way that I handle things is probably not the way you handle things. Considering that I'm more emotional than most people, I know that my mom is a very analytical person. She probably would not go about things the way that I would, because I'm based more off my emotions than I am logic. So we apparently tried to log in without checking my email. That's what happens if you have an important email and you don't look at it. We have some replies from people like Syllabus. Our Syllabro, he tells us a little bit about the Forest of Pain, but Haseo actually knows about the Forest of Pain, because in Dothak Roots, Haseo was one of two people to make it through the Forest of Pain. We'll actually be meeting the other person soon, but I probably will not tell you who he is until the third game. So, that's just how it is. Sorry to say, but you guys won't be needed. You guys won't know it's him unless you've seen Dothak Roots. Again, highly suggest it. Haseo, when he went through the Forest of Pain, he got an ultimate transformation that changed him into something else. He lost himself in his power, and I totally just smacked something on my table. But Haseo lost himself in his power, and he became this angry person, as you saw at the beginning, just at the beginning of this game, when you saw the way that he approached Bordeaux and the others, the way that he acted. So either we can be rude or Okay, we could talk bad about Adelie. Or we can, try to calm him. I see what it's doing. Yeah, this is the better option. The none of your business part kind of threw me off. We have a response from Gaspard! Gaspard, we love you. And, of course, Gaspard, he doesn't really know much. He can't really help us with Endurance. Whatever he knows is common knowledge, so we can act concerned, or we can be a jerk. So let's act concerned. Gaspard gets on my nerves, but I have a lot of friends that get on my nerves, but if people talk bad about my friends, I can't let it go. I get really upset, which anybody can vouch for. They know some of the people that I'm friends with online. When I listen to some of the things that I hear about some of my friends online, I get a little upset. Let's just put it there. Let's leave it there. And Pyrrhus III wants us to go on a quest with him and Gaspard. We will do in near time. But we have an urgent mail from Yata wanting us to come see him at Raven's at home.
Yata's calling me. Guess I'll go visit Raven's at home.
I guess we shall. So as I said, this episode's very heavily story-based. Because we're about to get more story, more things about what's going on in the world. This episode is also going to be a slightly bit longer than I was originally planning.
Yada's calling me. Guess I'll go visit Raven's at home.
I didn't originally intend for this episode to run so long, to be over 20 minutes, but because of all the stuff that we looked at the beginning of the episode, it's gonna run over. You guys don't mind, right? Last episode was probably really short. I don't know, because there was like an extra half an hour of when I did the grinding, so who knows? So, no one's down here, but of course everything occurs in the Serpent of Lore, so let's head in.
It seems that you have awakened, and you are now able to use your avatar.
Huh. Some aren't so happy with that.
Don't worry about Kun.
And are you okay with that too, old hag?
I will obey Master Yada.
Well, you sure are dedicated.
You would never understand.
Now, shall we get on about your mission? You are to investigate the area of my designation, and to attain a sample of the first level Ida. Now, do you have any questions?
How do you get it?
By using the Avatar's data drain, you can also draw out Ida's data.
Hey, you haven't forgotten what you said when you asked me to join GU, have you?
I have absolutely no qualms about rendering assistance to you in your search for Tri-Edge. Watch.
Well, not bad. Where do you want to go next?
I want to go eat something.
Okay, then maybe we should go back now.
What is this?
It's a record of an accident. An accident that happened about a month ago in the world.
What? Is that? Is he a PK? Hey, this doesn't look good, guys. Let's get out of here.
Run!
This is the same thing that happened to Shino.
Due to the shock the victim suffered from the attack, he is in a coma and has yet to recover.
You mean there are others like Shino out there?
We have a name for the players who have fallen into comas. We like to call them the Lost Ones.
The Lost Ones? What is he? An Epitaph user?
The only thing we know is he's not a regular player. Upon researching the access record for the area, we have found information that matches the three victims, as well as one other unknown player ID, which is suspected to be Tri-Edge. Those records remain on the logs. However, the entry record for the Chaos Gate in the same time period of the attack you just watched shows only three players.
In other words, he's getting into areas through means other than a Chaos Gate?
Yes, he sure fits the description of a ghost.
So, how the hell do we track down someone like that?
If we find out anything else, I'll definitely let you know. In exchange...
You want me to investigate Ida, right? Okay, fine. I'll do it.
Very good. I will notify you of your area of investigation later. You are dismissed.
So we found out more information about Tri-Edge. Feels so weird calling Tri-Edge, but you know. He is Tri-Edge. For some reason my controller would not move the character. It's like it died for a minute, but it's like it's not a wireless controller, so I was confused. But that's actually it for this episode. Next episode, we're gonna be doing some more stuff. If you're following along with this, do not log out. Do not log out and log back in, because once you log out, you're gonna lose what you won't be able to do what we're gonna do next and for a little while longer. So, with that everyone, I will see you guys next time.
その瞳に何が映る